buyers rushing headlong into buying SUVs and crossovers, do sports sedans really matter anymore? Well, Acura says yes. And proof of their conviction is this 2021 Acura TLX sedan. It's pretty much re-engineered from the ground up, has an all-new stiffer platform. Both front and back have a new wishbone suspension. It's longer, lower, wider, and it looks pretty darn good too. Now it'll also come with a V6, 355 horsepower, but that's not coming till the spring. So for right now, this is the sportiest model. It's the A-spec, and has a 272 horsepower, 280 foot-pound, 2-liter four-cylinder turbo, made it to a 10-speed auto. So, is all this enough to bring the TLX back into the sports sedan fray? We're gonna find out. Jump in the interior and the drama continues. It's a really cool design. Low profile dash, a very cool console, but the ergonomics are a bit of a mixed bag. We have some gauges that are red on silver, which is hard to see in the daylight. The screen, a 10.2 inch screen, is not a touch screen, it's out of reach. So you have to control it with this new touchpad here, which is a bit hit and miss. You get used to it, but you know what? BMW's iDrive control wheel is the best way, so why try and reinvent the wheel? Paddle shifters here, well placed, nice metal ones, but the problem is, this 10-speed auto is pretty slow to respond to shifter inputs. But having said that, this car is quick. Once past a little turbo lag, it moves out very nicely. Of course, people buying sports sedans are looking for performance. And how does this car stack up? Well, again, it's really interesting. It's a mixed bag. There's tons of grip. And turning is really quick, but it seems initially the back end of the car takes half a beat before it figures out what it wants to do. The ride is comfortable, and you know, for 90% of the time, the handling is great. So I was kind of originally going to say that it's not quite there as a sports sedan, but then went for this little track event at Cayuga. And all of a sudden, when you're actually hammering this thing on a track, it turns into a hoot. It's rotating, there's not a lot of understeer, but basically it's just kind of a nicely balanced, slidey, fun sedan that doesn't fall over itself with understeer. The thing is, on the road it's not as fluid as the best, like the BMW 330i or the Jaguar XE P300, which is a beautiful handling car. But as a cruiser and as a daily driver, this car is luxurious. It's smooth and it has tons of features for this just over $49,000 price tag. But I think for the true fight in this category, we're going to have to wait for the 355 horsepower V6 TLX that's coming in the spring. And I think that's when the fur is going to fly. For driving.ca, I'm Peter Blakeney.